the Predator Hera 8400 MHz is designed for high-performance gaming and professional workloads, pushing the limits of next-gen computing.
It syncs with ASUS Aura, MSI Mystic Light, Gigabyte RGB Fusion, and Astro Polychrome.
It supports EXPO and XMP profiles, allowing easy configuration for AMD and Intel platforms. With a clock speed of 8400 MHz, this RAM kit is built for overclocking and high bandwidth applications. It is optimized for low latency and high efficiency, making it ideal for gaming, video editing, and multitasking. The modules feature a high-quality aluminum heat spreader with a sleek, angular design, ensuring efficient heat dissipation. The matte finish
gives a premium look,
blending seamlessly with most PC builds. Designed with high-density memory chips, it delivers impressive stability even at extreme speeds. Integrated heat spreaders ensure effective thermal management, reducing the risk of overheating.
We start by booting at stock speed, checking the most basic performance. We must make sure to disable the EXPO profile and maybe even clear the CMOS if necessary. Now we activate the EXPO profile. And check the various debug codes. The EC and the AV debug error codes indicate us, together with the orange DRAM light, that something went wrong with our RAM. We will have to further check the cause. As a first step, I will try using one single DDR5 stick in order to obtain more data to give it to the MSI cardboard team. After a new clear CMOS, we activate the EXPO again on the single stick. We obtain a successful boot process. As a workaround, as we wait for a newer BIOS that solves the problem, we can activate a lower timing or a lower frequency in our RAM. In my case, I activated the 7800 MHz, which was the highest frequency that was not generating an AEB error code on my computer. So I contacted MSI and they asked me three things. First one is to clean the golden fingers of the memory sticks, second one is to try the memory sticks one by one, and third one is to try a new BIOS which is still not out for the broad market and tell them the results. Then I saw that both sticks work well individually but only in the A2 slot. I reported them so, and then they asked me to remove the water cooler, the CPU, and check for bent or fractured pins in the CPU socket. I did so, and I saw that everything was perfect, so I reported them back. In the meanwhile, I checked the A25 BIOS that they sent me, and I could see that there was an improvement. So I could run now at 8000 MHz and CL40, and I will publish soon a new video where I will show all the benchmarks that I did with these memories. To sum up, all that I can say is that while Predator Hera 8400 MHz is looking quite promising, compatibility is playing a main role as of today. So even when the 8400 MHz and a specific model that they have is listed and checked in the QBL of the MSI official support page, it's not having a good behavior. Therefore, all in all, if you don't have a lot of time or patience, maybe it's a good idea to stay with the safe bet of these 6000 MHz memory sticks. Otherwise, you can install this Predator Hera 8400 MHz with the hope that soon or later a new BIOS will come up with a solution for this problem. So I say goodbye for now, and you can stay tuned if you want to see the benchmarks of this memory. Goodbye. George.